News 8, the 10 o'clock update, was recorded for presentation at this time.
News 8, the weekend update with John Criswell, Steve Newman with weather, and George Reba with sports.
Good evening. Thanks very much for taking time out of your night to be with us. More than 5,000 people turned out in Fort Worth tonight to honor House Majority Leader Jim Wright. The gathering included several members of President Carter's cabinet, as well as an unexpectedly large number of protesters. Dave Cassidy reports.
Perhaps the last thing people attending the Jim Wright dinner in Fort Worth tonight expected to see were members of the Ku Klux Klan. But there they were, signs in hand, protesting Wright's performance as Fort Worth Congressman and House Majority Leader. The Klan members said Wright supports school busing, gun control, and lots of other things they don't like. Other protesters on hand included members of the Dallas and Fort Worth chapters of ACORN. They hope to acquaint Wright with their people's platform of lower utility rates and other consumer issues. The protesters were all polite. There were no incidents. And they certainly didn't hold down the crowd. More than 5,000 people came out to pay $25 for dinner and to honor Wright for his 25 years in Congress. Some of Wright's more conservative critics had suggested tonight would be a perfect time for him to announce his retirement. Of course, that didn't happen. And the crowd on hand certainly showed Wright has a lot of friends here. This was also the biggest gathering of national politicians in Texas since Lyndon Johnson's funeral 6 years ago. Secretary of State Cyrus Vance showed up. So did Speaker of the House Tip O'Neill, two other cabinet members, and several other congressmen, including Arizona Democrat Mo Udall, who paid tribute to the man who rose from mayor of Weatherford to become the House Majority Leader.
He comes from the old school and tradition of Cicero and Demosthenes and Daniel Webster and Dolph Briscoe, you know, great orators of all ages and time. And we're going to operate under the old rule of the Dallas Morning News, which says, if you can't say something good about a guy, then by God, let's hear it.
State Representative John Bryant, who has made it no secret he's out to beat Billy Clayton for Speaker of the House, says Clayton is out to get Bryant beat, period. And he's offering a bounty to anyone who will do it. More from Channel 8's Carole Kneeland.
It looked like a lobbyist party during the days of the last legislative session, but this was actually the annual reception sponsored by the Dallas Chamber of Commerce for Texas legislators attending the Texas OU game. House Speaker Bill Clayton was here, so was Dallas State Representative John Bryant, who's had many clashes with Clayton and is thinking about running against him for Speaker next session. Bryant claims one of Clayton's missions here was to find a candidate to beat Bryant out of his House seat next year.
Well, I think it's well known that the lobbyists and the Speaker go after the people that try hard to keep them from dominating the legislative process. They have in past years, and I think they are this year too.
Indeed, Clayton did meet behind this closed door with Larry Davis, an insurance man from Bryant's district who ran for his spot once before. Davis says he's running for the Dallas City Council next year, not John Bryant's Texas House seat.
Did Speaker Clayton ask you if you would run for that spot?
No comment.
Did he offer you any sort of backing if you would?
No. He did not offer any financial support. He didn't even mention anybody's name that was interested in giving any financial support. No money was talked about whatsoever.
Did you talk to him about the possibility of running against John Bryant?
No. We're concerned about our business.
What about John Bryant? Wouldn't you like to see him gone from the House?
Not particularly. John Bryant is running against me for Speaker, as you well know. And that doesn't pose any problems as far as I'm concerned, because I feel like I already have the speakership sewed up.
Clayton says his meeting with Larry Davis was one of many he's having around the state with people he thinks may be able to help him in a statewide race 3 years from now. Clayton would like to run for governor then. Carole Kneeland, Channel 8 News.
Another Texas-Oklahoma weekend has come and almost gone, complete with honking horns, hangovers, and scalpers. It all revolves around a football game that somehow seems to get lost for the better part of the fun fest. Channel 8's Chris Thomas reviews part of the frenetic activity of the last 24 hours.
For some, the day of the big game dawned very early as friends and relatives filled the small waiting room of the Dallas City Jail, and their 248 now sober cohorts trickled out.
For Robert Morrison, Douglas Cade. Anyone here for Douglas Cade?
This was not as much fun as last night's parties downtown Dallas, but it was the first opportunity to buy last-minute tickets to the game. There was scalping going on even behind bars. And just hours before the game, devoted fans swarmed the front of the Cotton Bowl, people with tickets trying to connect somehow with people without. The scene was kind of like the New York Stock Exchange.
Football tickets, Texas OU tickets, Dallas Cowboy tickets, right here.
If you didn't want or need a Texas OU game ticket, there were Dallas Cowboy game tickets for sale, as well as badges, flags, and hats to show your spirit. Inside the Cotton Bowl, spirit is what it was all about. Whatever the fans felt, they felt fervently. Over 72,000 of them making lots of noise. The buildup, it's hard to believe the game is really over for another year. About the end of the third quarter, the Oklahoma Sooner fans began quietly filing out of the Cotton Bowl. But they'll be back, not so quietly, next year, and the whole zany weekend will begin again. Chris Thomas, Channel 8 News.
Some of it's still going on, by the way. A street dance featuring several thousand people is underway at Fair Park right now. Police say all seems to be normal, which means nobody's been arrested yet. George will have highlights of the football game a little later in this news broadcast. In Tarrant County, the Lake Worth School District will have to try again to convince voters to fund a new high school. An exceptionally high number of voters turned out today to consider a $3.5 million bond issue for the school. But results tonight show the proposal losing by just 4 votes. The school district wanted a new school because a study showed the present schools are located in an area most likely to be hit by a plane if it crashed outside of Carswell Air Force Base. Superintendent Arthur Gregory tonight said the district will try for funding again as soon as possible. Lake Worth voters also defeated a maintenance tax in today's election. Parkland Hospital board members and staffers held a strategy session today on a proposed $80 million bond program. The key theme of the meeting, says Channel 8's Dennis Johnson, was space.
And we need space in order to, and equipped space in order to take care of our patient population as they exist now, plus what's projected for the next decade.
And to do that, Dallas County voters will be asked early next year to approve an $80 million bond package. The money would provide a new ambulatory care center and also renovate and expand other parts of Parkland. At this morning's meeting, representatives from the hospital's various departments outlined their special needs and concerns. And to no one's surprise, the message put before the hospital board and staff was simple. The facilities have been outgrown.
We've not expanded this hospital since 1970. We've grown at the rate of 5% per year in patient population.
And it's the population in Dallas County that will decide the proposal's fate. This is what the bond would do to taxes based on $100 of assessed valuation over the next 4 years. Board member Doris Holden said people may not be too thrilled about a tax increase, but Chairman Ralph Rogers feels if the electorate is educated about Parkland's medical importance to the community, people won't mind spending their money.
These particular tax dollars are tax dollars that I wouldn't look back at paying, see, now that I understand what it's all about. Now, if that kind of an educational job can be done, then the people of Dallas will respond favorably. And if that kind of an educational job cannot be done or is not done, I don't think you'd have a prayer.
Dates of February or March have been mentioned for the election, which will be set by the commissioner's court. The election will cost the hospital district $125,000, win, lose, or draw. Dennis Johnson, Channel 8 News at Parkland Hospital.
I'm Darren Hart, and I want to talk to you about mercantile momentum. So what does a 12-year-old know about banks? Not much. But since I won the All-American Soapbox Derby, I know plenty about momentum. Momentum is the difference between winning and losing. And momentum can work for you just like it did for me. And for me, the momentum that got me to the bottom took me right to the top.
When Joe opened his diner, he took an ad in the Yellow Pages. Me, and I got results. Business was so good, Joe fancied up the place, added a salad bar, then took a bigger ad. 4 out of 5 people use the Yellow Pages. Listen to that phone. Then Joseph expanded, put in chandeliers, and even said Merle in his ad. Business magnifique. Hey, you really doing a job. Let the Yellow Pages do your talking.
There's only one Broadway, and it's in New York. See it on the I Love New York Broadway show tours, and Braniff can take you there with the most nonstop flights. Every day, Braniff flies 10 nonstops to New York. Catch Braniff's nonstop performance to New York.
I love New York, especially in the evening.
Call your travel agent or Braniff for details.
President Carter answered telephone calls from 28 Americans and talked about inflation during a 2-hour public radio show today. Mr. Carter urged families to hold down their costs while the government battles to overhaul the inflation problem. Meanwhile, in Florida, the president is leading Senator Edward Kennedy in a poll among delegates to that state's Democratic convention. The straw poll is being used as a test of political strength. In New York, Cuban President Fidel Castro has settled in for an indefinite stay. Castro met for 3 hours today with Texas Congressman Mickey Leland of Houston and California Congressman Ron Dellums. He also talked with members of the news media. Mr. Castro is under tight security. It's costing $100 a day in police overtime, which doesn't sound like much. And Mexican officials at the runaway oil site today denied reports that oil has ever stopped flowing from it. Pemex officials yesterday reported a stop in a flow that resumed today. Those on the scene say the flow was reduced but never stopped. Archaeologists are all agog again this weekend over a giant find in a familiar riverbed. Dave Cassidy reports from Grand Prairie.
A long, long time ago, even before there were Texas OU weekends, most of Texas was covered by water, including this part of Grand Prairie. And recently, a former resident of the area was discovered along Interstate 20, an 8-foot-long fish, now a fossil. It lived here 80 million years ago, near the end of the dinosaur age. The fish was discovered by Robert Price of Dallas, an amateur fossil hunter who spends his weekends on the lookout for specimens like this one.
Each weekend, we'll just pick out a time in which we can just take off, pack a lunch, and go out and spend a full day in the field.
And Price says finding fossils is a tricky business.
One of the main things is to get on the fossil at the time it first becomes exposed.
Yeah, because this would have broken away, right? And just gone.
Yes, ma'am. The water's running down off here would definitely had it scattered all over out in this, completely destroyed.
When Price discovered this old fish, he notified the Dallas Museum of Natural History. Curator Charles Finsley will supervise the delicate process of moving the fossil to the museum, which includes dousing the bones with Elmer's glue. And at the site today, they found another fish and the bone of some unknown creature.
So this fish would have lived first, and then this fish, and that creature up there.
In the meantime, Robert Price says he'll keep looking for fossils.
I keep running into these large ones. I'm looking for a small fish. I don't have no room in my living room to accompany such a large creature as this.
Well, better luck next time. Dave Cassidy, Channel 8 News in Grand Prairie.
How chilly is it going to get? People keep asking me, should we bring in the plants?
No, not tonight, John. It's not going to get cool until probably tomorrow night. Even then, it's going to be in the low 50s. I'll have the forecast for Texas and Oklahoma next.
If a man's favorite threads prematurely lose their threads, and the seams in his slacks seem to disappear, then he needs clothes from Levi's Sportswear. Levi's slacks, blazers, and suits hold their great looks because they're sewn to the tough standards that made the Levi's name famous for durability. Men's clothes from Levi's Sportswear, where quality never goes out of style.
Wendy's Old Fashioned Hamburgers announces Wendy's Weekends at Six Flags. Stop by any participating Dallas-Fort Worth Wendy's and save three ways on Six Flags tickets. During October, buy a single hamburger, get $1.50 off. Buy a double hamburger, get $3 off. Buy a triple hamburger and receive $4.50 off your Six Flags ticket. So stop by Wendy's today for a hot and juicy single, double, or triple. And we'll see you at Wendy's Weekends at Six Flags.
This would be the biggest sale the company's ever had.
I want this deal.
Even halfway around the world, every important business deal boils down to that final yes or no.
You made a great presentation.
We made a great presentation. Well, this is it.
At First National Bank in Dallas, we understand. So when we do business with any business, we give you just what you expect from yourself.
We accept.
At First in Dallas, we give you results. Results, the real measure of a bank.
I know it sounds crazy, but all I wanted was a dining room.
It's the first.
Talk to Red Carpet Real Estate. We listen.
They really listened.
We had a high temperature today of 83 degrees. Last night's low was 67. We're currently at 70 degrees, humidity 46%. We have a rising barometer, east-southeast winds at 7, and of course, no rain. Let's take a look at the clouds from early this morning. This is what it looked like about 8 o'clock. We were under cloudy skies, but during the day, watched the clouds thin out, and by afternoon, we were mostly fair, but still some amount of clouds, particularly to the west of us, lingering. The clouds down in the southern part of the state dissipated by late afternoon, and we'll repeat the action one more time to make it absolutely clear that the panhandle was fair, as was West Texas and a goodly amount of eastern part of the state. Coming up next, the five-state regional map shows that some low clouds have settled in over our area, and because of that, I've updated the forecast to call for cloudy skies, but that just means they're low, thin, not rain-producing clouds and will thin out by tomorrow afternoon or by tomorrow morning, really, and be mostly sunny. You can hardly see them on late-night satellite pictures, so that's why I'm not showing it to you. There's no rain on our radar or any other radar in the state of Texas. 79 at Dallas, Fort Worth,
the 14th.
The State Fair of Texas.
Tickets at Preston Tickets and Sears.
Okay, now here are all the scores in the college football, beginning with the Southwest. Texas, a winner over Oklahoma 16-7. Baylor taking SMU with 8 seconds left in the game, 24-21. Houston over Texas A&M 17-14. Arkansas in an afternoon game over Texas Tech 20-6. TCU over Rice tonight 17-7, 111 yards by Jimmy Allen. North Texas State defeated New Mexico State 21-7. Around the top 20, Southern Cal, they will probably lose their number one ranking. They ended up in a tie with Stanford today, 21-21. Alabama over Florida, 40-0. Nebraska over Kansas, 42-0. A game just starting, no score in the first period, Washington and Arizona. Indiana lost to Ohio State, 47-6. Mississippi State lost to Florida State, 17-6. Notre Dame over Air Force, 38-13. Michigan took Minnesota, 31-21. Georgia over LSU, 21-14. An upset, Wake Forest took North Carolina, 24-19. Oklahoma State over Missouri, 14-13. An upset there. Brigham Young took Utah State tonight, 48-24. North Carolina State over Maryland, 7-0. Vanderbilt was a loser to Auburn, 52-35. Wisconsin over Michigan State, 38-29. And Purdue took Illinois, 28-14. Baltimore now has a 3-1 edge over the Pittsburgh Pirates. Game 5 coming up tomorrow here on ABC and Channel 8 with a 3:30 telecast. That should be an exciting game because they could wrap it up on the road there.
And because of that, we will not be seen tomorrow evening at 5:30 unless the baseball game ends quite early, and I can't imagine that happening.
I can't imagine.
Or if they're rained out. So, in that case, we will see you tomorrow night very late after the football game. Have a good night.